to maybe somebody who's trying to snatch a man from them. So listen to this as we close the show. Ninshitaya vundu wantende ka wishu ya tiwi kesha kupende nukufintu siyali elo na vena miyali elo na banda bandi antu wine sanda kesha kupende nukufintu siyali elo na vena miyali elo na banda bandi antu wine sanda tukapsana tukapsana dape na po more than you can imagine. Naliva we know that once and that we know, but it do not ever dare to cross my boundary. Nanguvela mewe, nanguvutukewe. I'll teach you a lesson I teach.
So that's it for today on Woman 360. We've had a very fruitful discussion. I hope you've picked out one or two things. The program can continue on Facebook. We can continue debating. Find us, Woman 360, like the page or give us a comment. But for now, that is it. I'm Judy Ngulube. Keep warm as you are trying to prevent flus, like I've been coughing the whole time on the program. Good evening.
I can cast a spell, secrets you can't tell.
Hello, and thank you for watching Woman 360. On the program tonight, we're talking about the Muslim woman. We're dwelling into her world, trying to understand her better, trying to even just erase some misconceptions, because I sat down with some Muslim ladies who just uncovered their world to me to just help us understand this better. And you know, the interesting thing about the Muslim woman that I found quite interesting is that they cannot appear on TV and they cannot talk on radio. So I was thinking, how am I going to do this? And I just said, all right, we're going to have this chat, but then I'm going to use other voices, and I'm just going to use pictures to cover it up. But then I still had to have this show and just share with my other ladies, without other people out there, even the guys themselves, just to understand how the Muslim woman works. What is it about the Muslim world that is so sacred, and why is it that it's so protective? So the voices that you're going to hear are not the actual voices of the Muslim women that I spoke to, but then it's the actual words that they spoke. So this is Woman 360. All right, this is 360 Degrees of Women Issues. This is Woman 360, and I am Judy Ngulube. In the studio to open this feminine show is gentlemen, three of them. I've got Desmond, Ariel, and Jesse, who have got a beautiful woman's song. But before they do that, maybe, Ariel, you wrote it.
Yes.
What were you thinking about when writing the song?
I was trying to honor my mom, mm-hmm. because most people have got a tendency of honoring their parents after they are late. Mm-hmm. So I wanted to honor my mom while she's still alive, so hence the meaning behind the song and me writing the song.
Okay,
yes.
Beautiful. I won't waste much of your time. I want to listen to the song. I want everyone out there to just listen to the lyrics, and it's a beautiful song. They'll open the show for us.
Brothers and sisters, you met you that you reconciled us. Oh, oh, and every time Papa left early for work, you met you that we were ready for school. Yes, indeed. I can't imagine having anyone more special in my life. Mama, you're the greatest gift from God up above. She's a woman, God's anointed and beautiful queen. Yes, I love her, she leads by example. Her words are full of wisdom, look at her. She's my
my father, she's a woman, God's anointed and beautiful queen. Yes, I love her, she leads by example, her words are full of wisdom. Look at her, she's married to my father, woman. Yeah, oh, she's married to my father, woman. Yeah, oh, she's married to my father, woman.
Fantastic. There's just something, the combination of the guitar, those voices, it just does it for me. I don't know about you people out there, but for me, it's just marvelous. Even though I'm a bit biased because I think my favorite instrument is the guitar. Wow. It's beautiful. Anyway, so this gentleman just sang that beautiful song for us to open the show. But talking about women, regardless whether you're Muslim, whether you're Christian, whether you're Hindu or whatnot, you're still a woman, and I think we still share those emotional things and the emotional part of a person as being a woman. We do share that. So as I'm dwelling into the Muslim world today, I first talked about them, about their dressing, their garment, the long flock that they wear. What is that all about? And they told me it's called the hijab. But why wear the hijab? This is what they said.
Hijab means to cover yourself, to protect yourself. Okay. It's like if you had a 10 karat diamond, what would you do with it?
Definitely.
Would you flaunt it?
No.
You'd put it away in the safe. You know, and this is how precious women are.
There you go. We've been given a reason why the Muslim woman wears the hijab, and also other parts of the garment have been explained to us. And it was kind of interesting to me, because when I was talking to these ladies, when they were among the ladies themselves, they actually took off the headgear and they had opened their faces. But when it was time to go, they covered themselves again. So I was curious. I asked them, why is it that among women, you have yourself uncovered, but when you're going out there, you cover yourself and just leave your eyes? At this point, I was given a practical example telling me that, let's say, if a man walks into a room with a woman, maybe there's a party or there's something that they've gone to in public, wouldn't you think if a husband, let's say a couple, wouldn't you think the husband will start admiring other women? And they say they want to protect husbands from admiring other women. Well, listen to what they had to say.
Imagine if your husband was here with you and we were all uncovered and he spots a more beautiful woman than you. Don't you risk losing him. For you not to lose your husband, we're protecting your husband from us. Our two men who are we not allowed to marry, which is your brother, your father, your son, your uncle, you know, those people you don't cover from. You know,
so the majority of rape cases and women being attacked mostly is because men are after those women. Because obviously, if they see a woman who attracts them and arouses them, then obviously they'll go after that woman.
Yes.
So we're protecting society by covering ourselves. Because if you see, obviously, if we're covered, then no man is going to look at us with that gaze.
Yeah.
Oh, I want
they've got nothing to see then.
Interesting concept right there from the Muslim ladies. But then again, and it's nice to know that at least brothers, fathers, and sons get the privilege to see their women uncovered, and like the other men who are probably the suitors or just men who are not related to the woman definitely don't have this privilege. They also brought out the issue of HIV and AIDS as well as rape. They said if you're uncovered, you won't really make somebody admire you. You won't make somebody have that lust to do something that's evil or maybe even just go and rape you. So that's some of the reasons that I've given for wearing the hijab. But then again, I wanted to know, since there's so much importance and protectiveness attached to the Muslim woman's dressing, the Muslim woman's garment, is there a difference in what a married woman wears and what the unmarried one wears? They said this.
The dressing up, does it differ?
We all have to dress.
See, there's just different levels. One is just a scarf, covering that is from the Quran. Basically, it's a sheet.
Okay, it's good to know there's no discriminating. You won't feel that if I'm not married, I have to wear this, or if I'm married, I have to wear that. They said it's the same thing. Whether married or unmarried, you still have to wear the same thing. Now, I go to the other thing, which is the color. I noticed that most Muslim women wear black. Why the color black for the hijab?
There's no chance of anybody looking at them and them. They're protected, basically.
Okay. What about the color? Everyone just... black.
It's,
but
just, it's unattractive. Because we're protecting your husbands from us. It's the best way to explain it.
All right, okay, so now that color, talking about the color of the hijab being black, brought me to another concept. Why is it that there's so much limitation, there's so much protectiveness, and does it mean that the life of a Muslim lady is oppressed? Are they forced into a certain lifestyle? This is the answer they gave me.
I live here alone. I don't have a father. I don't have a brother. I don't have a son. So who's forcing me? I have understood this whole thing from my experience.
Wow.
You know, really, it is experience that teaches you a lot of things. And I said, now you tell me, who's forcing me to do this?
There is your answer for all those people who've been thinking a Muslim woman is oppressed, she's forced into a certain lifestyle. They've denied it themselves. Now, when you talk about a Muslim woman, there's a part in the Quran that says, heaven is under a mother's feet. Now, this just goes to tell you how important a woman is in the Muslim world. And they also stressed it by giving me other examples and explaining it further. Listen to this.
You know the status that the Quran has given a woman? Mm-hmm. It is said that heaven is under the mother's feet. What greater status does a woman want? That if your children don't give you your rights as a mother, mm-hmm. they will never see heaven. Whereby if they look after their mother, if they look after their wives, if they look after their daughters, automatically this. The Prophet said that those of you who have two or three daughters, and you bring them up with the correct values in life, that is the Islamic values in life, and you find them good partners, mm-hmm. and you take good care of them, they will be in heaven with me like this. And he put up his two fingers together. And he said, you'll be in heaven with me like this. So now what more do women want? Whatever we do, we are not oppressed. We are not forced. We have been given so much rights that if my husband comes home and says to me, what have you cooked? And I say to him, I was very tired today. I haven't cooked. If you're hungry, go cook and eat. I have a right to do that. I mean, if we've got the status of having heaven under our feet, what mm-hmm. else do we want?
All right, so that's what they're saying about, you know, just a woman being important, regardless of whether she's a mother or not. That's how important a woman is in the Muslim world and, of course, across the world at large. Now, what about the child? Talking about being oppressed and being forced into a certain lifestyle, because I've seen some Muslim girls who are very young still wear the hijab. Do they feel that maybe they're punishing the children, or are the children really willing to wear the hijab? They gave me this answer.
I think they see us and they get the inspiration of wanting to do what their mothers do, what their sisters mm. do, you know, their older sisters do. It's nothing to do with the mothers wanting to dress them like that. Mm. They just feel they want to be part of the community. They want to be part of the women, you know. They want to be just like their mother. So this is
and
why it's so
how
important.
They're brought up from young.
Yeah.
All right, there's an answer again. Now, moving on with the program. When you talk about heels, makeup, bangles, accessories, and things like that, every woman loves that. Well, maybe just the degree of how much makeup, how high the heels are, or how much accessory she puts really does differ from woman to woman. But definitely a woman has interest in that. Now, if you're covered from your head all the way to the bottom, why wear this, or why put makeup, why put accessories if the Muslim woman does put this? I was curious and I asked them if they did. They actually agreed. They said they do, but then it's only to be shown to the husband. Well, listen to what they had to say.
This is on so that nobody gets attracted to me. If it's black, okay, somebody will look and look away. But if it's a bright color, somebody will keep looking and say, oh, wow.
That's nice.
Yeah, that's
Okay. Then they'll see my height. They want to see the hands.
Then
they want to see more than the hands.
Then, yeah, then they'll see my height and they'll say, my God, she's a tall woman. She's slim and she's so, look at her walk. You know, these are the things that attract men to you.
We
wear everything. We wear lipstick, we wear makeup, we wear everything. But we hide ourselves.
We do waxing, we do everything.
Let's
but
everything.
We do it in the limit. We don't
you
wait for strange
because
men.
You
do it for your husband.
Yes. No, yeah. You do it for your husband. If you don't have a husband, mm-hmm. you do it for yourself.
Just
you want
to
look
good.
You want
feel
to feel good.
Good.
Okay. You don't need to dress for somebody else. You know, whereby now the whole concept is, I'm going to walk in there and look like a model.
Mm-hmm.
Because I want to show myself off to other people. Mm-hmm. Whereby I can wear the most stunning outfit, most beautiful makeup,
mm.
but if I'm not doing it to feel good or to look good for myself,
mm.
I'm not going to have the confidence to walk into that party.
All right, very interesting concept right there. I don't know, people watching, what views you have, but if you have any views or you have any comment, you can find us on Facebook, Woman 360. Like the page or give us a comment on the program that we are having right now. It's on Muslim women, Muslim women and their world, and just going into it and just wanting to find out more about the Muslim woman right there. And then if you are a Muslim woman out there and you've been Muslim maybe since you were born or you just joined the Muslim society, there's another thing that they don't do. As you've seen and as I said earlier, they don't appear on TV. They don't have their voices on radio. They don't have to have all this public appearance. But then I couldn't help it but ask, if they don't do this, then don't they feel oppressed? Then why protect them so much from this? And they gave me this answer.
Okay, if you look at the rest of the world,
mm-hmm.
and you look at the Muslim world,
mm-hmm.
where do you see more crime being committed?
Okay,
Do you hear a lot of rape cases in the Muslims?
Mm-mm.
Do you hear a lot of immodesty in women? Do you see Muslim women half naked walking around?
Mm-mm.
You don't. And therefore there's no crime.
Mm-hmm.
Whereby the rest of the world is so unprotected,
mm-hmm.
that everything is happening to them.
Mm-hmm. We can't
women
just
are not allowed to voice, meaning I can't go on air and speak.
Even
like
radio,
this.
Nothing.
No, the same way we try to protect everything.
We protect our voices.
Yes.
Okay.
You know, I can start talking on the radio with a seductive voice,
mm-hmm.
and that might attract somebody to me.
Mm-hmm.
And now they're going to start investigating, who is this woman talking behind?
Okay.
Who's talking on air?
Mm-hmm.
And then they'll pick it up, and then they'll go and investigate, and then they'll find out from ZNBC, oh, it's so-and-so.
Mm-hmm.
And then he's going to come looking for me.